Hello everyone, this is Rajiv Kohli and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And in this tutorial I will show you that how you can create this fire camp animation in PowerPoint 2016. You can make it more better by using the right combination of colors. It is totally up to you. And this animation is totally inspired from one of the animation by Rose Lee at codepen.io website. So let me show you that how I have drawn these fire leaves in PowerPoint. And for that, go to insert, shapes, and draw an oval here. Make it larger by holding the control shift and alt keys. Make a duplicate of this oval by holding control and shift key alone, and then just drag and drop it right here when you will see that guideline. Now select both of these leaves by holding the shift key, and from the format tab click the merge shapes drop down button and choose intersect. Zoom in a little bit and go to edit shapes, edit points, and here I will delete that point by right clicking on it and click delete point. And for that point I will use the handler to adjust the shape. And that is how I have drawn these fire leaves. And later you can duplicate this leaf and can rotate it right just like that. But I have applied the grow shrink effect, as you can see here, grow shrink and spin effect on each of the leaf. So if you will apply the grow shrink animation like that, set it to play with previous and set a growth rate of 125% vertically, auto reverse, and repeat it until end of the slide. Then you can notice one thing here in the slideshow, that the leaf is expanding on both sides and the anchor point of expansion is right here. So what I need is, I want to expand it only vertically and I want the bottom part of the leaf to stay right here. I don't want to move that point here. So for that, if I select this leaf here and go to the format tab and change the fill color, then you can see an oval here, and that I have grouped with this leaf here to change the anchor point position. Now the anchor point position is right here, and if I delete this oval, then the anchor point will get right here. And now if you will expand or spin this leaf, then it will work according to the anchor point. So you can watch my video on how to define a custom anchor point in PowerPoint 2016, and the link of that video is available in the cards. So that way I have applied the anchor point on each of the leaf. However, I have drawn only the one leaf, and later I have copied all of them, duplicated them using the copy paste command, or you can select an object and press Ctrl D to make a duplicate, and later you can rotate them as you like just by dragging and dropping. So for the woods, you can use insert, shapes, and use freeform. That is one of my favorite tools, and you can quickly draw these woods using the freeform tool. And for that, click right here, then here, just continue clicking, and later join the end part with the starting point. And now I will draw some oval on the top of these corners like that. Now hold down control shift and drag and drop them on the top. Hold down the alt key when you need to adjust the size according to your mouse movement like that. Okay, now I will go to the shape wheel. We'll use an eyedropper, or I can also pick a color right from this color palette, or you can go to eyedropper and click on the color that you want inside the oval. So again, I will use that color, and for outline I will use this color, and will increase the weight of the outline. So that way you can quickly draw objects in PowerPoint, just like that. Or later you can select an object, go to Home tab, double click Format Painter, and then start clicking on another objects, and that will fill the same color and outline color to those objects. So that is how I have drawn these shapes here. And for the background, the lightning background, as you can see in the slideshow, what you have to do, you have to insert an oval here, make it larger by holding Ctrl Shift and Alt keys, drag it on the top, go to Shape Fill, Gradient, Mode Gradient, and here you need to select the Gradient Fill option, and here you have to define the colors that you want to use. And for the right color, I will choose this one, and I will increase the transparency of this color to 100%. And for here, I will choose a lighter color like that. And later you have to send this over to the back, just like that. So that is how I have drawn this shape, and the animation is very simple. So let me close this format shape dialog box, select it and delete it. And here I will delete all these animation and will let you know all the animation that I have applied from the beginning. Select the first one, hold down the shift key, select the last one and hit the delete key. So first of all, I will start from the center big leaf and go to the animations tab, click add animation, apply grow shrink, set it to play with previous, with a duration of 0.50 seconds, and without any delay timing, open the effect option window. I want to increase the size to 125%, only vertically, no smoothness, set it to auto reverse, and in the timing tab, set it to repeat until end of the slide, hit OK key. Now again select the big center leaf, go to add animation, and this time apply spin animation, set it to play with previous with a duration of 1 second and 0 delay timings. Open the effect option window. I want to rotate this to clockwise with only a 50 degree rotation. Set it to auto reverse, no smoothness, and repeat until end of the slide. Hit the OK key and let's see the slideshow. So it is totally up to you that how you want to rotate these fire leaves. So for the next leaf, just select the leaf here and go to the animation printer once, click it once, and then click on the left leaf. And again, while selecting the left leaf, click on animation painter once and then click on the right leaf. And you have to repeat these steps for the rest of the leaves. And if you want to do it quickly, then just double click on the animation painter and start clicking on the rest of the objects. So what next you have to do is to change the duration and delay timing of these effects to create a fire animation. So for the big left leaf, for the grow shrink effect, I will set the duration to 0.50 seconds, but this time I will add a delay of 0.50 seconds. And for the spin animation of the left leaf, I will choose a duration of 1 second while having a delay of 0.50 seconds. And for the right leaf grow shrink effect, I will choose duration 0.50 seconds and a delay timing of 0.25 seconds. And delay timing of this effect will remain the same. And it is up to you that how you want to apply these duration and delay timings, and that will change the fire effect. So for the small leaves, what I am going to do, I am going to change the duration and delay timings of these small leaves. And for this one, I will shorten the duration of this effect to 0.25, and for this spin effect I will set it to 0.50, and for this center leaf I will add a duration of same, but will add a delay timing of 0.25, and that will go the same for this. And I want to reduce the radiation duration of this effect to 0.75. However, you can also change the grow shrink rate. Like I want to grow this leaf to 120% alone, and I want to rotate this leaf to 18 degree. So that way you can add more combinations. I would like a delay of this leaf to 0.25 while having a little shortened duration, 0.25 delay and 0.50 for that. Let's see the slideshow. So it is, again I will let you know that it is totally up to you that which color combination and which spin and grow shrink rate you are using that will can create more stunning effect, fire effect in PowerPoint 2016. And I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by leaving your valuable comments in the section below. And don't forget to hit the like button and do share this video with your friends. Thanks for watching and have a great day. Yeah.